Hello everyone! In this video, I'll be reviewing the Mandalorian and the Child quarter-scale statue by Iron Studios. This is truly an amazing statue, and it's also the very first statue by Iron Studios to make its way into my collection. You might already have seen my unboxing video for this statue. In that video, I showed you the box and its contents, as well as the assembly process. But in order to just briefly recap, the statue comes in a relatively large box, and the statue itself is encapsulated between two styrofoam halves that are held together by two durable Velcro straps. The packaging felt very secure and protective, and the statue also arrived safe and sound all the way from Australia to Denmark. The artwork of the inner box is very plain and simple. It sports the traditional Star Wars design with the black background and grey edges. I honestly don't know where this design originates from, but it has been a staple of Star Wars collectibles for many years. The image on the front of the box is simply a photo of the statue, and aside from that, you have all of the typical branding and licensing information. There's no fictional writing or backstory, which would have been a nice little extra touch. For instance, some background information on the Mandalorian, his heritage, or some info about the code that governs his life would have been perfect. This statue features the two main characters of the TV show, the Mandalorian and the Child. You see the Mandalorian in a calm walking pose, wearing his prestigious Beskar armor, accompanied by the Child inside the familiar egg-shaped pram floating right next to him. When I look at the design of this statue, I get the impression that this is an artistic representation of the Mandalorian, more so than a piece that is trying to convey a specific scene from the TV show. In fact, it somewhat challenges the timeline of the show to see the Mandalorian wearing his Beskar armor while walking next to the floating egg-shaped pram that holds the Child, because in the TV show, the Mandalorian hands over the Child, including that pram, to the client, and in return receives the valuable Beskar metal that is later forged into his armor pieces. As such, you never actually see the Mandalorian in his Beskar armor upgrades while also walking next to this particular floating pram. That is why I think that one should look at this statue as more of a representation of the character, or maybe even the first season as a whole, since any inaccuracy that you might spot is either deliberate or non-essential to what the statue seeks to achieve. It seeks to capture the essence of the characters and the entire first season of the TV show. The props used on this statue are there to help convey this story, and to me, it works quite well. Originally, I was actually planning on getting the premium format version of The Mandalorian by Sideshow Collectibles. However, I decided to cancel my pre-order, and the main reason for this was that I never really found the pose of the premium format appealing. The pose of the PF seems too peculiar to me. He has this odd stride that I simply don't feel matches the walking style of The Mandalorian when you see him on screen. And when I at the same time had seen early concept photos of the Iron Studios version, it was clear to me that I wasn't going to get that perfect representation of this character that I desired with the premium format. This is not to put the PF to shame in any way, and in all sincerity, it looks decent, but my fascination with the character and the show runs so deep that only the very best to me would be able to fill that hole in my collection. So after having scoured the internet for days, I came across an Australian retailer that would let me put in a pre-order, and I didn't hesitate for one moment. And here we are today. I have to say that I really like this statue. By no means is it a flawless statue, but to me personally, it does so many things right. First and foremost, it feels like the Mandalorian. The simple yet determined walking pose is just right for the character. It just feels very authentic, and even though we've already established that there are some inaccuracies going on here, it feels like this design has been pulled straight out of a scene from the show. It simply manages to capture the essence of the character. The craftsmanship of this piece is also very impressive. I know for a fact that this piece underwent some design revisions during its early stages. On some early photos of the prototype, the helmet had this kind of trapezoid shape when viewed from the front, with the sides leaning inwards towards the top dome. This was later changed so that the helmet looked slightly larger and with straighter, more parallel sides. This gave the statue a much more accurate look and was a critical change in my opinion. The statue is fully sculpted. This is something that I'm also very thankful for. I feel that a fully sculpted statue will withstand the test of time much better than one that features mixed media and fabric parts. It's way easier to dust off, and if kept in proper conditions, it will keep looking like new for years. Sure, mixed media will also last for many years if maintained and kept properly, but nevertheless, it's more fragile and demands more care. The details and textures of this statue are very well done, and even though it is fully sculpted, the various parts of the Mandalorian's armor look highly realistic. This applies to all parts of the suit, including fabric, leather, and metal parts. The texture resolution of the leather parts could have been scaled down a bit, but I feel that it doesn't harm the overall presentation of the statue. This is a highly detailed statue, and you'll find all of the small pouches, straps, and equipment on it that you might have noticed when watching the TV show. These small details are all very well executed, and the paint application on these is very well done. Talking of paint application, there are three areas on this statue that I feel are really well done and worth highlighting. Firstly, there's the Beskar armor pieces. These have all been given a thick, glossy coat that really makes them pop. As light passes through this thick, glossy coat and hits the underlying texture, all of the details really emerge and create a very convincing look. There's a slight wear to the armor pieces, so they don't look too perfect and clean. The helmet has a more smooth texture, but it has the same glossy surface. It looks really remarkable, and it really draws your attention to it. I find that Iron Studios did an excellent job with these armor parts. The next area that I would like to highlight is the Child, or Grogu. Yeah, let's stick with Grogu from now on. I find the paint application here to be very well done too. His flesh tones are well blended, and his eyes look deep and lively. For a quarter scale sculpted rendition of Grogu, I find that this version hits the nail quite convincingly. I love how he is sitting in the front of the pram, holding on to the edges. It accurately conveys the curious nature of Grogu. Lastly, I also want to mention the base. Sure, it might seem like a relatively simple base with some simple colors and not much going on really, but I find it to be perfectly muted in its color palette so that attention remains centered on the character, or in this case, characters that are standing on top of it. I've never been the greatest fan of large and elaborate bases, since I often find them to be too distracting. Sure, in some cases it will work quite well, but I personally prefer the pieces in my collection to have some degree of subtlety to them. This simple base fits perfectly into the narrative of the first season of the show and provides a great frame for the characters. It has this strong post-Return of the Jedi vibe, just like the show tries to give us, with the worn and half-buried Stormtrooper helmet on the ground. Once assembled, this statue feels like a solid piece. The arms are securely fastened to each side with strong magnets, the cloak rests securely around his collar, and the helmet locks firmly into place. There are also no visible seam lines, which is also a big plus. The pram is also secured with a strong magnet on top of the tall rock on the base. This gives the illusion that the pram is floating next to the Mandalorian. To be honest, it's quite obvious that the pram is touching the rock, but for some reason I never really notice it. It also gives me a nice peace of mind to know that it rests securely on top of the rock and not on some flimsy and fragile transparent rod that might fail at some point in the future. The only piece that could have been attached more securely is the rifle on the back. The magnet on my sample feels secure enough, but I've heard from other owners of this statue that it feels weak and somewhat unreliable. That's not really the feeling that I get from mine, but it's definitely wobbly to say the least, and that's despite the fact that it sits on top of a peg right on the cloak. But I'm not at all concerned or worried that it'll ever fall off. As a side note, now that we are talking about the rifle, there is no visible strap connecting to the rifle, so it sort of just sits on the middle of his back. As such, this is definitely a statue that works best when seen from the front, or maybe from a 45 degree angle to either side. I don't really hold this against it, it's rare for a statue to look equally fantastic from all angles. One thing that could have elevated this statue to a whole new level would be the inclusion of some swap out pieces. For instance, imagine if another portrait had been included that showed the face of Din Djarin. Yes, I'm aware that we don't really see his face much in the show, and especially not in the first season, but it would still have been a really cool option, Some of the most memorable scenes of the entire show are the ones where he takes off the helmet. Another option could have been to be able to exchange all of his armor pieces with the older legacy armor pieces. That would have made this statue into almost a two-in-one, where you could choose to either have him wear his Beskar armor or the brown armor he wore prior to receiving the Beskar armor. The only obvious downside to this would be that you'd have quite a few loose parts on this statue, and I often do prefer when a statue consists of as few pieces as possible to give you that sense of solidity that the word statue kind of implies. I also think it would have been cool if Iron Studios had chosen to include a certificate of authenticity and maybe even a piece of printed artwork to accompany this statue. This is something that I generally feel that more companies should consider doing. I know that such a thing doesn't quite fit into the whole cost efficiency model that these companies try and stick to, but it really elevates the overall experience of acquiring a new collectible to also be provided with a nice COA and a decent print that can be displayed next to the statue. I might be old school when I'm saying this, but that's just how I feel about this. To me, it simply showcases how dedicated and passionate a company is towards its products, and in the end, I just appreciate the collectible even more. I remember that when I first assembled this statue, it felt quite strange and very unusual to place the main character away from the center of the base and instead closer towards the edge. Obviously, it all comes together nicely once both the Mandalorian and Grogu have been placed onto the base. Once you do that, everything looks perfectly natural, and it makes much sense given that the two characters are supposed to share the limelight. It does, however, shift the weight of the piece slightly, and you have to be mindful of this if you were to pick this piece up. Also, given that the Mandalorian is standing near the edge of the base, his rifle sticks out quite far from the base. I therefore highly recommend that you remove it before picking up the statue. Alright, I think it's about time to wrap up this review. I'm extremely happy with this statue. It's a really well-crafted statue, it's solid, and it gives you a strong sense of quality, and both the paint application as well as the sculpt is on point. The walking pose is perfect for this character, and it is done in a really realistic way. To me, it is the perfect representation of the Mandalorian, and I really like how this statue splits the attention between Mando and Grogu. The show is about the two of them together, and this statue successfully manages to convey this message. As a quarter-scale collector, I feel so pleased to have this piece in my collection. It ticks all the boxes that I consider to be the most important ones. It's fully sculpted, it's an artistic representation that captures the essence of the characters and the show, the base is simple but fitting, and lastly, it's forgiving in terms of size and space requirement, which means that it can be displayed with relative ease. I still feel that the art box could have been more interesting, and if this piece were to come with a COA, a nice print, and maybe some swap out pieces, then this release would have been perfect. At the time of this recording, it can be quite difficult to obtain the statue, and I've also been told that the distribution of this statue was kind of rough from the very start. But if you happen to stumble upon an opportunity to get this piece, I'd highly recommend that you pick it up, especially if you love the show as much as I do. I truly hope we get to see more awesome statues and collectibles based on the Mandalorian in the future. But for now, I consider this piece to be the best option when it comes to a Mandalorian statue within the quarter scale realm. Alright guys, that's all I have to say. Thanks a lot for watching this review. I hope that you'll drop a comment below and also like this video and of course subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot for sticking around, and I'll see you guys in the next one.